Kelkar. I am Pallavi Mahagaukar. I am working as an assistant professor at Arts, Commerce and Science College. This lecture series is created according to the syllabi given by Savitribai Phule Pune University for the subject Electronics Microcontroller. Today, we are going to learn about the timer control register. As we know that we have two timers in 8051 microcontroller, timer 0 and timer 1. To control that timer, we need to set some value into this TCON register. So TCON stands for timer control register. This timer control register is bit addressable. Bit addressable means you can address any single bit at a time. No need to give the total byte value for the loading of TCON register. So if you look at the bit format of this TCON register, the upper 4 bits are actually reserved for your timers. Timers flag bit. So these 4 bits are reserved for your timers and the lower 4 bits are reserved for your interrupts. First of all, we will look into this TR1 and TR0 bit. This TR1 and TR0 stands for timer 0 or 1 run bit. So TR1 is for timer 1 run bit. TR0 means timer 0 run bit. When we want to start particular timer, we have to set one value into this bit. Like, suppose I want to start timer 0 timer, then to start that timer, we have to assign TR0 is equal to 1 value. This indicates starts timer 0, and to stop that particular timer, we will assign 0 value into that particular bit. So this is for timer 0, same we will have for timer 1. So in that case, we will write TR1 is equal to 1 to start that particular timer. So this is timer run bit, which is used to start and stop the timer. This we have to write or we have to set using software. So we will set this value or clear this value when we are going to do the programming. Now the next one is TF1 and TF0. This TF1 and TF0 are your timer overflow flag bits. So this is timer overflow flag bits. What is this timer overflow flag bits? For example, suppose you are using timer 1 in mode 1. So if you are using timer 1 in mode 1, that is 16-bit timer mode. So when you have 16-bit timer mode, the lower value which you are going to load into timer is 0000H and the maximum value is FFFFH. So your timer, when it reaches to maximum value with one more clock cycle, it is expected that it should get reset to 000. But to indicate that overflow action, this flag bit will set to 1. So this indicates timer has reached to its maximum value, and after one clock cycle, this timer flag bit will get rise. This is timer flag bit. Then in the programming, we have to clear this beep. For example, the set action of this timer flag beep will be done by hardware, but for that matter, while doing the programming, we have to clear this flag beep for the next iteration. In case of interrupt, it is automatically done by hardware. Now let us look at the next 4 bit, which is lower 4 bits of your timer. As we know that there are 2 hardware interrupt. One is INT0 and other one is INT1. So these are external hardware interrupt 0 and external hardware interrupt 1. So whenever we have these 2 interrupts, for that matter we are going to use this 4 bit. Also we know that there are 2 types of triggering. The first one is level triggered and second one is edge triggering. This level trigger and edge trigger we will discuss afterwards. But when we have edge triggered interrupt, so either INT0 or INT1 has been arrived at that matter, to indicate it is edge triggered, we have to assign value 1 to this. So when INT1 or INT0 is 1, it indicates that particular external hardware interrupt has been arrived and it is edge triggered interrupt. So it will have the edge triggering action only when this bit, particular bit, is 1. So when it is 1, it is edge triggered interrupt. And when this particular bit is having value 0, it indicates that this hardware interrupt is low level triggered interrupt. So for that matter, when it is edge, it is actually falling edge. Particularly for falling edge means from high to low pulse. So this INT0 and INT1, this particular bits are set or reset according to the triggering action of hardware interrupt. Example, suppose INT1 is arrived and it is level triggered, so this particular IT1 will have value, if it is edge trigger it will have value 1, and if it is level triggered it will have value 0. So this is about the IT1 and IT0. Now let us look at the last 2 bits, which is IE1 and IE0. This is interrupt edge triggered flag bit. So this is interrupt edge trigger flag bit. So when INTR interrupt is arrived, for example INT0 interrupt is arrived, when this particular interrupt is entertained by microcontroller, this particular bit, that is IE0, will be assigned as 1 value, indicating that interrupt is in process. When the total interrupt service routine has been processed, automatically this will reset, this will have the value 0. So this indicates interrupt is in processing action or not. We have two external hardware interrupt, external hardware interrupt 0 and external hardware interrupt 1. To indicate which interrupt has been arrived and the processing is going on, we are using this interrupt flag bit. So this is all about the TCON register. To summarize the total bit format, the upper 4 bits are reserved for the timer, lower 4 bits are reserved for the interrupt. To start the timer, we use TR1 and TR0 bit by sending value 1, and to clear or to stop the timer, we'll assign the value 0. Then TF1 and TF0, these are your timer flag bit, overflow flag bit. Whenever timer is in overflow action, this timer flag bit will get or will have the value 1. And you have to clear that value in the software when we are using a normal timer programming. Then we will look into the lower 4 bits, which is IT1 and IT0. These are in case of external hardware interrupt 0 and external hardware interrupt 1. So to indicate whether it is level trigger or edge trigger, we are using this IT1 and IT0. When the value is 1, it is edge triggered interrupt, and when the value is 0, it is level trigger interrupt. And last two bits, which is IE1 and IE0, this interrupt indicates a flag bit for the edge trigger interrupt. So when INT0 interrupt is arrived, this IE0 bit will rise to 1, indicating that that particular interrupt is in processing action. When the total processing is completed, automatically this will set to value 0. So this is all about the TCON register. Thank you.